In this video, we're going to add sounds and music to our game. Because this is a 2D game, all of our sounds and music are going to play from a single game object, our sound manager. Let's create that now. We're going to go to game object, create empty, and we'll label this sound manager. Now that we've created our sound manager, we're going to add two audio sources to it. The first audio source is going to play our sound effects. The second is going to loop our background music. Highlight the sound manager, choose Add Component, type Audio, and select Audio Source. We'll click Add Component a second time to add the second source, and again, select Audio Source. Next, we're going to create a new C# script to control when our sounds are going to play. We'll highlight our scripts folder, choose Create, C# script, and we'll label that Sound Manager. Let's open it up in MonoDevelop. We're going to start by declaring two public variables of the type audio source called effects source and music source. Next, we're going to declare a public static variable of the type sound manager called instance and set it to equal null. We're going to declare two public floating point variables called low pitch range and high pitch range. We're going to use these to add a little bit of random variation to the pitch of our sound effects. We're going to initialize these with the values 0.95 and 1.05. The numbers 0.95 and 1.05 represent plus or minus 5% of our original pitch. This allows us to have a small variation in pitch that will cause the sounds to sound slightly different when played, but not produce big, drastic variations in pitch that will be distracting. We're going to change our start to an awake function, and we're going to use the same singleton pattern that we used for our game manager. In awake, we're going to check if instance equals null, and if not, we're going to set it to this. Next, we're going to check if instance does not equal this, we're going to destroy this game object. Finally, in awake, we're going to set our sound manager to don't destroy on load. Next, we're going to declare a public function called playSingle, which we're going to use to play single audio clips. PlaySingle is going to take a parameter of the type audio clip. We're declaring this as a public function and giving it a parameter of the type audio clip so that we can call it from our other scripts that are executing the actual game logic. Audio clips are assets which contain digital audio recordings. In this case, our audio clips are our sound effects and our music loop. In PlaySingle, we're going to set the clip of effects source to the clip that we passed in as a parameter. Next, we're going to play the clip in effects source. We're going to declare another public function that returns void called randomizeSFX. RandomizeSFX takes an array of audio clips as a parameter. To do this, we're going to use the params keyword. The params keyword allows us to pass in a comma-separated list of arguments of the same type as specified by the parameter. In this case, we'll be able to send any number of audio clips to this function as long as we separate each one with a comma. The first thing that we're going to do in randomizeSFX is we're going to declare an integer called random index, and we're going to generate a random number between 0 and clips.length, the length of our clips array. We're going to use this random index number to choose a random clip from the array to play. Next, we're going to declare a float called random pitch and set it to equal another random number, in this case with the range being between our low pitch range and high pitch range variables. Then, we're going to set the pitch of effects source to random pitch. After setting the pitch, we're going to set the clip to our random index choice from our array clips. Then, we're going to play the clip. So what we're doing here is we're just creating a little random variation, both by playing alternate clips randomly and by randomizing the pitch a little bit. This is just going to keep our sound effects, especially the ones that we're going to be triggering again and again and again, from sounding too repetitive and annoying. We can delete our update function because we're not going to need it. And then let's save our script and return to the editor. In the editor, our next step is to attach our Sound Manager script to our Sound Manager game object. Let's drag it on. And then we'll highlight the Sound Manager and we're going to set up our component references. Let's drag our first audio source to our effects source slot and our second to our music source. Next, let's add our music loop to our second audio source. We'll use the asset picker. Choose the audio clip Scavenger's Music. We'll set this audio source to play on awake, which is the default, and we'll also check loop so that the music will loop. We're going to turn off play on awake for our first audio source for the sound effects. Let's give that a test. So we can hear that our music is playing, but importantly, we can also hear that our music is not being reset every time we change levels because we set the sound manager to don't destroy on load. What we're going to do next is we're going to add the needed code to the player script to play sound effects as the player moves around and takes actions. Let's open the player script in MonoDevelop. What we're going to do in player is we're going to add 7 public variables of the type audio clip, which are going to contain our sound effects, including 2 variations of each sound effect. Because Game Over Sound is just going to play once when the player dies, we only have a single variation of that, whereas we have 2 for each, which are going to be randomly switched between using our randomize SFX function. The next thing that we need to do is to play these sound effects at the appropriate moments when the player is taking different actions. The first thing that we're going to add is going to be an attempt move. In attempt move, what we're going to do is we're going to check if move returns true, meaning the player was able to move, and then we're going to play one of our 2 move sounds using randomize SFX. We're passing in our 2 audio clips as a comma-separated list, and because we're using the params keyword, they'll be added into our array that we're using to select our clips randomly from. Next, in onTriggerEnter2D, if the other game object's tag is equal to food, we're going to call randomizeSFX, giving it the parameters eatSound1 and eatSound2 for the food objects. And we're going to do the same for the soda objects, passing in drinkSound1 and drinkSound2 as parameters to randomize SFX. This is going to cause us to play our sound effects when we pick up our food or soda objects. In check if game over, if food is less than or equal to 0, we're going to play our game over sound, and we're also going to stop the music playing on our music source. Let's save our player script and return to the editor. Back in the editor, we're going to assign the sound effects for the player. Highlight the player. To assign our MoveSound1 variable, we're going to click on the asset picker, and we're going to select Scavenger's Footstep 1. For MoveSound2, we're going to do the same and select Scavenger's Footstep 2. For eatSound1, we're going to select Scavenger's Fruit1. For eatSound2, we're going to select Scavenger's Fruit2. Drink sound one is going to be scavenger's soda one. Drink sound two will be scavenger's soda two. And game over sound will be scavenger's die. With those set up, let's add the needed code to play our sound effects to our enemy script. Click on enemy in our scripts folder, double-click to open in MonoDevelop. In our enemy script, we're going to add two public variables called enemy attack 1 and 2. We're going to use these to store the clips we're going to play when the enemy attacks the player. And then in onCampMove, after we set the animator trigger to play the enemy attack animation, we're also going to call randomizeSFX, passing in those two public variables that we declared to play the enemy attack sound effect. Let's save that and return to the editor. Back in the editor, let's add our audio clips to our enemies. We go to our prefabs folder, shift-click to highlight enemy 1 and enemy 2, and for our attack sound 1 variable, we'll click the asset picker and select the scavenger's enemy 1 sound. And for attack sound 2, we'll select the scavenger's enemy 2 sound. With that done, we're going to add our sounds to our wall. Let's go to scripts and open our wall script. We'll add two public audio clips called chop sounds 1 and 2. And then in damage wall, we'll call randomizeSFX. Let's save our script and return to the editor. Let's add our chop sounds to our wall prefabs. Shift-click to select them all. And then we'll choose Scavenger's Chop 1 and Scavenger's Chop 2. And now, let's give it a test. Now that our sound effects and music are working, it's time to move on to our last step, which is adding our touch-based swipe controls to the game. We'll do this in the next and final video.